Crossing my playmates. That's the difference, Ruthie, between games of skill and games of chance.
Or not knowing which side you're on. We're going to Singapore in one of those?
Certainly not. That's the vessel in which we're to be lost at sea.
Lost at sea? Paul, I think you'd better explain your secret plan just a little more fully. All of it. He's awake up, I tell you. He should be here by now.
They used the back road so the van wouldn't be spotted.
The police? That's it, they've been caught.
Most unlikely. It'll be some time before the van's missed and even longer before the drivers are discovered.
In case he is awake up, you never know what's going on inside people's heads.
Why aren't you working on your escape clothes?
What clothes?
The ones you're making out of the material you stole.
Oh, and I thought you were on to us.
What do you mean?
We were pulling your leg. Oh, you make up that sort of thing all the time to relieve the boredom.
Yeah, hell, you wouldn't catch me going down a hole in the ground.
Yeah, we really had you going for a while there, didn't we? I almost started believing it myself.
You're lying.
Listen, sweetie. If I say there are no escape plans, you had better believe it. But if you don't, I'm liable to get very nasty.
Don't do this. Don't do that, or you'll be locked in your room. Don't cry, you're not a child anymore. Sit up straight. Remember who you are. Be a lady. Don't speak back to me. You do as you're told. Damn you! I won't! I won't! You're always setting the rules. Well, I won't let you. You're not going to tell me what to do anymore. You'll make me hurt you like the last time.
You're from the club a bit from behind. Oh, I should wring your neck.
No, please. No, don't hurt me. Don't punish me. I wouldn't hurt anyone, I promise.
You ever touch me again and I won't think twice about killing you.
I won't. I know too much. But you can trust me. We're friends, aren't we? How'd they turn out?
She's beautiful.
Yeah. Can I have them then? Because they're mine.
No, they're not. Why do you want Megan's photos?
Megan? But that's Elizabeth. Come on, quit fooling around.
Don't you touch them. They're mine.
You give them to me, you silly bitch!
You're not gonna take her away from me!
Let me have them, your brain in the dark! I'll kill you if you don't give them to me! Get away from me!
What's up? Something wrong with the steering?
It's Pamela.
What?
She's trying to kill me.
Pamela?
the head.
I don't believe this.
Supposed to be here for another couple of hours.
Oh, I'm so sorry. If it's inconvenient, I can come back.
No, you're never an inconvenience. You're always welcome in my home, especially when you bring me such beautiful flowers. Please come in. Now, surely you've got better things to do than to spend your Saturday afternoon with an old lady.
Believe me, I don't. Not that I wouldn't want to be here, even if I did.
Don't worry, it's fine. So which foolish boy has let you down this time?
Oh, even worse. My friend ditched me. I was supposed to have lunch with my housemate, Rosie, but she got a better...
These are on the doorstep when I came in, and I don't think they're for me or Ollie.
Amazing. Life is beautiful. A better offer. You know, Mary, why don't I go down the shop and get some scones? Not much of an afternoon tea without them, is it?
Oh, don't worry. I've got some nearly ready. They just need a bit of kneading and I can pop them in the oven.
But you've already done enough cooking for me. It's about time I start pulling my own weight.
I like cooking for you. I'm a mother. That's what we do.
But you're not my mother. I'm really uncomfortable with this, Mary. It was rude enough of me coming over early without any notice, so...
Don't worry, it's no trouble.
Please, Mary, I want to go. I won't be long.
Of course.
Seems to be deadlocked.
This 10-year-old kid missing on the Nullarbor. Well, when they found him, he was sitting by a dam having a roast dinner. Well, it turns out that he'd walked to the nearest watering hole, killed a lizard with his pocket knife, and just waited to be rescued. Now, is that Aussie resourcefulness or what, eh?
Yeah. Yes, it's amazing what we can do when we're pushed to the limits.
Yeah.
Yes, would you excuse me for a minute, please?
Well, no need to ask permission, Don.
My tranquilizer.
You might need those here, mate. There you go.
The ferry comes and goes once a day, folks. There's no airstrip on the island, but we can always get your helicopter and an emergency.
And I'm very good with my hands, you know.
You'd lost interest.
Look, I know I haven't been by as often as I should, but, well, I have been flat to the boards.
Wouldn't want to be a fool if she thought a man could be happy with just seeing her for a few minutes every now and then.
That depends on how much he cares. And he could care one hell of a lot about it.
Good to see you again, Bea.
Hello, Ken.
You look terrific.
I did the best of what I had, which wasn't much to start with. Will you go inside? A lot to trust someone.
Mm-hmm.
How long's your wife staying with you?
Well, she's probably gone back already. She had no right coming here.
Well, I do the same thing in her shoes. She's your wife. She'd be a fool not to regret missing all those years with you. Now, spending a lifetime with someone doesn't mean as much as just a few hours with the right person, you know. There's nothing more important than two people caring for each other. You're lucky if it happens to you once. And it's worth holding on to no matter what you have to do for it.
Do you know what I like about you?
You did tell me once.
You are a very special woman. Don't ever change. Marion and I are going to give it another go. It's a gamble. We both know we'll have to work at it. There's got to be give and take on both sides. Oh, hell be if it was anyone else but you. I don't want you to feel I'm letting you down.
I can do anything I put my mind to. I'm strong, remember? I suggest you leave. Now.
I haven't finished speaking to B yet.
Oh, that's all right. I think you said it all. Be happy, huh?
Please understand.
Yeah, sure. The funny thing is, it seems to be me that has the difficulty of making people understand.
My God, B, I'm sorry.
Just let me put these down for a sec, because I need both arms free. Now, come to Lou, you little stunner, and give us a big kiss.
Lou! This is so unexpected.
Oh, come on. You must have been wondering where today's flowers have got to. So, here we go. Personally delivered. Now, that's worth another kiss, isn't it, eh?
Oh, no. You remember Harold, don't you?
Harold. Harry Bishop. Great to see you, mate. You haven't changed a bit. Well, put on a few kilos, maybe, but still the same old jelly belly Bishop, eh? It's Lou. Lou Carpenter.
Well, 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 yes, so it is.
This must be Charlene. By gee, you're the spitting image of your mum when she was your age.
Charlene, this is Lou Carpenter.
The Lou Carpenter? The one you went out with in Brisbane?
Yes.
The one and only.
Listen, you've had it right. You went out. But you've got to do things properly.
But how?
Just leave it to me. I'll think of something. You go home back to bed. And be a good girl. And say I'm sorry.
And back to the ballet and the French and the art and the speech lessons and all that. So, I can speak beautifully and move with grace, and he can show me off to all his smarmy friends and have me perform like a circus seal. I don't want to be a lady, Winston.
First, we'll take the cash register. Now, when you make a sale, you ring the amount up, right? There's dollars. There's cents. Pull the lever, put the money in, and if there's any change to give, take it out. Got that?
You've got 15 minutes drive from here. We should be there and back with no problem.
Well, I got a light afternoon. I don't mind being a bit late.
Oh, who's that?
What? Sister Jeffries.
No, the other one.
Dr. Holland. He boards with me.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, pay attention, pay attention. Now, if you want to take anything out of this without ringing up a sale or anything, you just do what I did, you know, pull the lever like that. But you mustn't push any of these if you haven't made a sale, you know, if you're not putting money in. Otherwise, I'm going to be out of pocket, you know, at the end of the day. My balance won't show right.
Oh, can I try?
Yeah, oh, wait a minute. Here's your first customer. This is my new assistant, Gail, Mrs. Gordon.
Hello.
Hi, what'll it be?
Well, I've already phoned down his just sandwiches, but yeah. I'll have a coffee.
Yeah. Oh. There's the sandwiches. There's the coffee.
It's 45 cents. Or 90 cents. How much for the coffee?
No charge for the staff.
Oh, great. I drink a lot of coffee.
It goes on my account.
Yeah, there's the account. Right, it all in there.
Oh, I didn't get to use the register.
Your time will come, my dear. Now, listen, do you feel confident to be by yourself while I take my trolley around?
Sure, no sweat.
I wish you was up to change a $10 note for me.
What?
Yeah, and another thing that she's...
What's next?
Well, I'll leave you to it, Ada.
Yes, right, Dennis. Girl, there seems to be some money missing from the till.
Missing?
Yeah, $20 note.
Oh, yeah, I remember seeing it there.
It isn't there now.
Well, I wonder what would have happened to it.
I don't know, but Dennis said you changed a $10 note for him this morning. Now, you told me you didn't have any money.
I didn't tell you that. I said I couldn't afford a sandwich. The money was the rent I'd saved on my room.
Oh.
You don't think that I took the $20?
No, no, of course not, love. No, no, it'll turn up somewhere.
Now, look! It was on the floor.
Oh, what did I tell you? I told you to turn up. Oh, girl, look, I'm sorry if I sounded as though I thought you took it.
Oh, that's all right.
No, it isn't really. I'm really sorry, of course, I didn't at all. I knew. Hello.
Hello. I won't be finished till about 4:45, so do you want to wait or go ahead and start?
No, I'll go ahead and start the tucker.
Right.
All right.
Now, you must be a terrific cook. Those recipes you saw on TV looked fantastic.
They were.
Now, can you really make all these things in this book?
Of course I can. I wrote it, didn't I? Yes, they're all beautiful. You want me to prove it, do you? All right, that's enough for three. Would you like to come and join us?
Oh, I couldn't do that. Push to all that extra trouble.
Oh, come on, you've worked very hard. I bet you're hungry.
Oh, that's really nice of you. I'd love to. Thanks, Mrs. Simmons.
Okay, love, you're on.
Big hug on. Hit me, or dare ya.
Right, stand over there on that line.
Blimey, paws off me.
You're going to learn to do as you're told, young lady.
Georgina Baxter, you've been sentenced to a period of 6 months imprisonment, having been found guilty of assault and bodily harm. Is that correct?
Answer when an officer speaks to you. Oh,
we better get you to the examination room. It could be broken.
Broken.
Don't worry, we'll see it doesn't ruin your looks.
Is that correct?
Right. See, she gets into a uniform, will you, Officer Barfield?
I ain't getting to them rats. You try to put them on me, I'll scratch your eyes out.
Ow! Right, that does it. You're going to spend some time in solitary till you learn to do as you're told.
What about the showers?
Do you want to risk it?
No, thanks.
All right. Will you be all right? Mm-hmm. Better come with me.
Bunch of turds!
Up against the wall or you won't get any breakfast. All right, take it in, Miss Barfield.
Oh, what you got in there, Mr. Fletcher? A mad dog.
Good day, love. What they shove you in?
No talking, Lizzie.
What are you staring at your bag?
Don't go, huh? I just wanted to thank you for everything you've done for me. I mean, if it hadn't been for you, I might have been as sick as bee.
Oh, I didn't do much.
Yes, you did. And not only did you look after me, you gave me that medicine. I might have died without that.
Well, I wouldn't let that happen. You're my friend.
Yeah, I know that. And I care about you, too. I care about you more than just a friend. You know that, don't you?
You bitch! Oh, you dirty, filthy dyke! I thought you were my friend! You make me sick, you sick bitch!
What's going on?
He kissed me.
All right, come on, outside.
I suppose you'd change your mind and come and live with me when you get out.
Nah, I don't need to fight like we did before. I've got to lead my own life.
Yeah. Well, I better be going.
Yeah.
Goodbye, Georgie.
Hey, do you reckon you could come and visit me? Let me know how you're going.
I'd like that. Bye.
Bye, Mum.
But you left something off? It must take hours to put it back together.
Depends how good you are.
Oh, yes, Mr. Modesty. So how good are you?
Well, I was top apprentice in my year.
Oh, yeah?
It's true. I could rebuild one of these babies in record time. It's a wonder they didn't put me in the Guinness Book of Records.
Okay. All right, I'll organise it.
What?
The Guinness Book of Records.
Why?
I'll tell you how good you are. Come on, you're not going to chicken out of it, are you?
No, of course not.
Hey, this will be great.
We have an emergency. What is all this?
Look, it's a record attempt at engine assembly. What is it?
Chris just rang from a Rubule. A man's been stabbed. Sam's going to meet us at the airport.
Oh, I should have made a note of it. Mrs. Sullivan, how do you see yourself being employed?
Oh, well, it's a question I ask of all our clients.
Well, I thought something to do with bookkeeping. Part-time.
Part-time? Well, as you can see, I did matriculate with honours.
Yes, I have the certificate with me, actually. 1918, Mrs. Sullivan. That is quite some time.
Putting a man in charge of female prisoners, and a man separated from his wife, too.
Like putting Dracula in charge of a blood bank.
Show them any kindness at all, and they always abuse it.
Well, I've just been around to the union members in the other blocks, and there's very strong feeling against the supervision of visiting tutors, or any classes if it comes to that.
Well, there'll be some strong opposition from the do-gooders in the department.
Well, they just have to put up with it, won't they? It's hard enough to get the staff to carry out normal duties, let alone the extra work involved in supervising rehabilitation projects.
Exactly. And if it comes to the crunch, I know the members will definitely strike.
Well, that'll be a laugh. The prisoners will think that we're taking a leaf out of their book.
What do you mean?
What haven't you heard? The prisoners in the laundry have gone on strike over this braille machine business. There was a danger of the project falling through or the classes being cancelled because we haven't got the staff to cope with it.
So they've actually gone and done it. I'm going to see the governor.
Come in.
Can I see you for a minute, Mrs. Davidson?
Yes, Mrs. Power, what is it?
I've just heard about the women in the laundry going on strike.
Yes?
Mrs. Davidson, this strike isn't being caused by a few disgruntled women who think they're going to miss out on some new privilege. This is a deliberately planned strike, led by none other than our so-called education officer.
David Andrews?
Yes, and I can prove it.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mr. Andrews. And how are we this morning?
Fine.
Good. Looking forward to another fun-filled day improving the lot of the underprivileged?
Can't wait to start shedding the light of hope.
Oh, how fortunate the little darlings are to have you as their mentor. Now, Mr. Andrews, almost forgot. Mrs. Davidson, she'd like to see you in her office.
Any idea what for?
Got a fair idea.
It's a secret, is it?
Oh, I think she'd like to tell you herself. The governor wants to see you in her office, and that's an order.
When will that old rocker learn to leave me alone?
It's no way to talk about the governor.
Mrs. Powell has been permanently promoted to chief prison officer. Congratulations, Mrs. Powell.
Congratulations. Thank you. Thanks, Mrs. Davidson.
I have a little something that might interest you. B. Smith is now on kitchen duty.
So?
Well, she'll be collecting a little extra shipment in with a normal delivery. A shipment just for the women.
Shipment of what?
Extra food, goodies, does it matter?
Where are you going, Smith?
Take the dirty laundry to be washed.
Bit of a come down for you, isn't it? From top dog, working the press, to pushing the laundry trolley around. They usually give jobs like that to old legs like Lizzie. As a matter of fact, I'm not sure that this trolley isn't too much for you. Why don't you unload some of the stuff? Come back for it later.
I'll manage.
Okay. No. No, on second thought, Smith, I don't think you should take all of that stuff. Excuse me. History. You should be careful of what you eat and smoke.
As you are probably aware, Mrs. Morris, due to personal reasons, was unable to accept the position of deputy governor. So I therefore have pleasure in announcing that Colleen Powell has been appointed, and I officially offer my congratulations. I'm sure she will do an excellent job.
Thank you.
Okay, tell me.
There is an intruder. There's a snake.
Snake? You called me out here for a snake. No, I mean, if it found its way in, it'll find its way out again, won't it? I mean, what do you want me to do about it?
Well, I don't know. Get rid of it. I pay my taxes, don't I?
I don't know. Do
don't
you?
Don't answer that. Oh, look at that. Oh. The cord on the vacuum cleaner.
Look, are you two going to get down and give me a hand or what?
Never forgive me for this.
customer, is he? Please be seated. Well, we're here today to celebrate the love that Rosemary and Terence have for each other and to give social recognition to their decision to accept each other totally and to share their lives. Okay?
You must be Dr. Standish. I felt it was time we welcomed you to the district. I am Cynthia, Compton Brown, and this is my daughter, Lisa.
I've been just dying to meet you.
Oh, really?
Yes. There are so few interesting new people out here. You're from Sydney, aren't you?
Yes, that's right. I'm feeling a bit...
My daughter was at school in Sydney. I think she misses the bright lights. Not that we don't have our own entertainment. Have you ever been to a bachelor in spinster's ball?
No.
We're hosting one next week. Do come.
They're such fun. People fly in from just everywhere.
Well, I'd be delighted.
Splendid. Well, we'll see you this afternoon at the official opening.
Traveling, I love the idea of seeing new places and new things. But once I get there, I want to be home again, safe and secure. I would think the transition from New York to Bellburg would be rather more terrifying.
I've never lived in the country before. It's so quiet, so empty. Oh, it mightn't have been so bad except that I didn't come by myself. I was with my fiancé, and he's in Wodonga.
Well, that's not so far away.
I had a letter from him a couple of days ago. We split up. It's all over. Oh, he was so excited about it all. It was one of the things I resented. Childish, I suppose.
No, I don't think so. Well, Sonia, I'm afraid there's not really much else I can do to help you.
You've helped us by listening.
Well, I'm available for that any time you like.
Thank you, Doctor.
Never mind. Come on in. And to what do we owe the honour, etc., etc.? And can I offer you a drink?
Oh, no, thanks, Adam. I can't stay very long. I'm glad you're here, Rog. There's something you can both help me with. Or rather, someone.
Oh, not one of my erring pupils, I hope.
No, it's Miss Rosen, Sonia.
Ah, we were just talking about her. I don't think my articles in the Clarion have helped her image very much.
Look, she's not sick or something.
No, she did come to see me, but just to talk. Look, I don't think I'm betraying any confidences, but I'm a bit worried about her. Well, she's homesick and depressed, and there's one or two other things. And I thought, since you're the only two people she knows in the town, apart from the Turners...
Well, you think you'd like us to take her out, see the sights?
Well, I think it might help a bit.
All right. What about Sunday?
Well, that's a good idea. We're going fishing up at the lake. We could make it into a real bush barbecue, you know, swing the billy and all that bit.
Well, fine. That's if you think she'll come.
I think it sounds ideal. Why not try and talk her into it?
There's the front, widow. Then march me off to the shower. Matter of fact, I feel like a nice hot shower.
That's enough. Listen, there's something you're going to have to learn. You want respect from me, you're going to have to earn it. Like maybe I'd like to see a bit coming my way. I know this prison, probably better than anyone. You just remember that and you might be okay.
You never knew Murray Winter, did you?
No, she seems okay.
Well, she was top dog before B here. She used to get the girls all bashed up by her heavies just because they wouldn't do what she wanted to. And every buy-up day, she'd come round and take half our fag order.
Really?
Hmm. I reckon we should stick by Sandy, Jude. Otherwise, Mari's going to take over. Can't trust her an inch.
Oh, no, get out!
Somebody treat
her. Crushing me, I can't breathe.
I'm not pushing that hard. I just want a bit of information, that's all. You're good information, aren't you? Not the stick of them beating the cops these past 3 months.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You gave my letter to Fitzwater and the cops, didn't you?
They set me up. They said they found a witness to get me off the murder charge. It was just another policeman. They tricked me.
Well, what'd you expect? That's what I do in all the grasses. And you were a grass, weren't you?
Uh-huh.
I'll give you one more chance to tell me what you did with Edwards.
I didn't do anything to her. She set you up. She said if I helped her get away, she wouldn't hurt me. It was a setup. She fooled you. It was all Sandy's idea. I didn't want to trick you. She was going to kill me.
Oh, you didn't have much choice then, did you?
No.
Either she killed you then or I kill you now.
Noticed you didn't have any lunch, Winter.
I wasn't hungry, Mrs. Powell.
I'll go and eat something anyhow. Keep your strength up.
The old girl can't keep her eyes off us. She only knew who it was.
Continue.
Aren't you going to help her? I came to say goodbye to David. I've done it.
Driver.
The governor's nephew will be there, won't he, Mr. Watson?
Okay, Mrs. Gallagher, he certainly will. And I assure you, it will be a momentous celebration. Worthy the occasion and the company.
Yeah, I'm sure. Watson's purchased just about every ounce of goods in Mitchelton for this, as I hear it.
Oh, terribly convenient. Of course, we have everything sent in from Melbourne, but it does get rather tedious.
Oh, Watson, you remember our daughter Penelope, don't you?
How do you do, Mr. Watson? So nice to see you. It's been such a long time.
You've been at boarding school, haven't you?
Yes, the ladies' college. But that's all over now. It's off to France in the autumn.
Unless I get married first, of course. Isn't that right, Mother?
That's assuming you find a suitable partner.
My father...
Look, a friend of mine got in a whole crate load of these, but he could only use half of them. I thought perhaps you might like some in the church.
Oh, well, that's very kind of you. Actually, you could have waited for Harold to bring them. He's bringing some more things down shortly.
Oh, is he?
Yes, there must be something in the water at Ramsey Street. Not that I'm complaining, mind you. Never look a charitable act in the mouth, as they say.
As they say.
You right with us?
Yes, yes. Rosie, look, I wonder, could I have a word with you for a tick?
Well, yes.
Somewhere private.
We are in a church, Lou.
Yes, I know, but...
All right. Come into the vestry.
Great.
So, what did you want to say to me? Don't shut the door.
Big one?
That's a self-locking door, and the key is on the other side.
Oh, does that mean...
We're stuck here. Until Harold arrives. So, what did you want to tell me?
Truthfully?
Yes, you've got all the time in the world now.
Well, I just wanted to say how much I am looking forward to coming to dinner.
Good.
Oh, yes, yes, there was something else too.
How do you want to play this?
There's only one ace of spades in the pack and there's only one Kate Peterson in Wentworth. Get the card, you get the doctor.
That'll do. We're going to have to wait till she gets out of the pound, though.
Just heard she's out. Must be at the second sitting for dinner.
Looks like your lucky day.
I'll let you know.
I reckon you earned that, bro. Just make sure you collect your winnings real soon.
Okay. Let's run through the details once more.
We get Kate away from the others, and then you create a diversion, and it had better be a good one.
They're the only kind I know. You're not talking to an amateur, you know.
I didn't think I was.
Well, just you remember it. I might be in on this, but that don't make us mates, okay?
This is no time for arguments. We can sort out our differences tomorrow when our good friend Kate is 6 feet under, okay?
This is intolerable.
Oh, stop whinging. You're better off carrying the bloody bin than being inside it.
Why don't you both save your breath? I'd like to see this garbage going out this week.
Ready for our little chat, then?
Hold it. Edwards and Peterson are missing.
Maybe they went for a walk.
Where's Edwards?
I don't know.
How are you feeling about the move, Ellie? Leaving here. Well, Steve gave up the city life to marry me. I suppose it's fair enough that I should be prepared to do the same thing. It'll work out.
It's only a pun, Ellie. Just a pun.
Yeah, well, we're taking it together. That's the important thing. If you give him trouble, he might, I don't know, warn them or something.
Oh, I'm not some big-time criminal, nothing, darling.
Well, I know that. Well, is he going to charge you with trespassing or whatever it was he said you were doing? Can't charge you, can he?
He can do what he likes. He's the law.
Oh, Steve. You don't want to go back there any more than I do, do you? You don't want to leave here either.
Oh, it's not a question of want, darling. We haven't got a choice, that's all.
No.
What do you want?
You told me to report here. Oh, yeah, that's right. You're on private property. That's trespassing. That's an offence. I'm going to give you an official warning. Next time, I'll charge you. Is that it?
That's it.
I wasn't trespassing. I had permission to be there. I know those people.
Yes, and I know you and hundreds like you. Any more back chat and you're gone. Understand that?
You're not in the city now, Nolan. If you're looking for a payoff, you're not going to get it. I can't afford it.
Who said anything about a payoff?
I know people like you too. Hundreds like you.
God, it's hot.
Get used to it. We've got a while to go yet.
This if he finds out the tape even exists.
We may have to do the same to Terry if she doesn't play. I'm not going to have you end up like Martin, so we've got to make sure, and quickly, that Robert doesn't find out.
Well, if he does, I won't be going on my own. You'll be just as dead as me.
And Terry?
I don't know who you are.
I'm Barbara Hume. I've been doing some work for Charles.
Get out!
I'm not going to hurt you, Terry. Please believe me. I've got to talk to you for your sake as well as mine.
To switch sides. One minute you're all over Charles, the next minute you're here telling me you want to help me.
You live with him.
Don't remind me.
Well, it's easy to get sucked in. He told me all sorts of things about you, and I believed them.
What did he say?
Oh, that you never got over being dumped by him. That you'd do anything to get back at him. That you'd destroy him if you could.
And you believe that?
I did. I believed everything he told me.
I didn't.
You did once.
He had me fooled for a while, but I've learned a lot since then. You must think I'm really stupid. This is just another way of breaking down my guard, isn't it?
Somebody must have believed you when you said you wanted to get out.
What made you change your mind about him?
Lucy. She trusted me and I was using her. I really want to get out, Terry. And I think I need your help.
Well, how about a cup of tea?
No, thank you.
I'm told you're to teach me Serbo-Croatian.
Yes.
Very nice. I hope we'll be friends.
We shall get to know each other, Major, probably very well. But we shan't be friends. You spoke to Major Barrington?
I think I have the wrong person. He said to contact a Captain Fulton.
Sit where you are. I'm Captain Fulton. How was Major Barrington when you last saw him?
Dead.
When?
A month ago, near Yeche.
If he gave you a message, it must mean you were with him when he died. Why has it taken you so long?
I'm a medical officer with a partisan mobile force. The commissar would not release me. I'm AWL.
I may as well tell you that Major Barrington and I worked very closely together. Now give me the message.
I'm to contact you. You're to arrange that I meet a Colonel Smythe in London. I am to tell him Operation Overlord and give him four names.
What names?
I'm to report in person.
Oh, out of the question. What are the names?
He stressed it. He said, tell no one here. We're penetrated.
I'd suggest you tell me a little more about yourself. I'm not sure yet how much I can believe of what you say.
You use my information. You can't keep me in here. You pig, you use it!
Come on, Pinson, come on.
Nobody uses me! I'll kill you.
Join the queue, lady. There's a waiting list.
You can't keep me in here forever. I'll kill you, all of you. You're all liars and cheaters, filthy!
Congratulate the jury on bringing in the only verdict possible.
Filthy common scum.
You have been found guilty on all charges, Peterson.
Don't and you Peterson me, you pompous idiot. You will address me as Dr. Peterson.
Be quiet.
I am a respected member of this community. I demand to be treated as such.
If you don't stop,
and
I'll hold you.
You have the nerve to call yourself a barrister. It's a sad day for society when you qualify it.
Order.
How
order.
Dare you, city cretins? How dare you, you cretins?
Order. I sentence you to 10 years imprisonment with a minimum of 6 years to be served concurrently with your present sentence.
I take it you weren't too happy with your trial. Well, the girls are going to give you a trial you'll be crazy about. God, you women are childish. I'm not interested in playing your stupid games. Oh, you will be, Kate. I don't even know what the game is yet. Meet Justice Sandy Edwards. Unfortunately, Sandy couldn't be here in person. But then you'd know all about that, wouldn't you? We're going to give you a fair trial on all the charges the cops missed. Now, if you're innocent, well, you'll be as free as a bird. But we haven't abolished the death penalty. So if you're found guilty, you're dead. And that's where Mari comes in. She's our public executioner.
You want to know something, Doc? You're dead.
You've lost, Faulkner.
Get in the van.
G'day, Doc. Looks like we're going to be making this trip together.
No!
Hell.
You all thought you could beat me, didn't you? I'll show you what my rock is.
Sure you do. They've got a new office for you there, too. Nice pad of walls.
All right, Gatlin.
Goodbye. I hope you'll all be better soon.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I knew the day you came into my office you had a different kind of quality. A sort of mysterious something. Whatever. That bloody original, darling.
Yeah, that's it, you know. The Sphinx. Ages. It's maturity and wisdom contradicted by a youthful facade. But that's a very potent mixture. But look, there's not one man here today who hasn't been looking at you.
Not you, Mother.
You really are a dreary little so-and-so, Jay. Do you mind? Somebody's going to overhear you one of these days and think I really am your mother. No, it's impossible.
Joe,
yes,
the clients are really getting restless.
Oh, I'll be over in a second, I promise.
Okay, now, what's going on? Are we all getting the lights on?
I read your comments on the TV contract. You know, you really are incredible. I mean, you picked up on things that I'd question. Where on earth do you learn about contracts?
Just gut instinct, I guess.
Well, if you ever decide to pack modelling in, there's always a job for you backstage. Could do with a good head around the place.
Oh.
Good morning, Madge. Oh, I've never been here before. Quite a quaint little house.
We find it adequate for our needs.
Yes, I'm sure it must be.
So what's happened? Some disaster befallen the Professional Women's Association?
Oh, heavens no. But there has been a change of plan. Oh, my goodness, is that your speech? Oh, quite a hefty document. And judging by those bags under your eyes, you've been up half the night working on it. Really, it's very remiss of me not to have let you know about this change last night.
Just exactly what is the change?
I've had to allow extra time in the programme for an address by the mayor. So you now only have 5 minutes.
5 minutes?
Well, I'm sure that's more than enough time for an overview of your life in the coffee shop, isn't it?
Well, I wouldn't want to bore the members.
5 minutes, then. Just edit out all the boring bits. I'm sure you'll end up with a much better speech. I'll see you at the meeting, dear.
What's wrong?
Kent, she was damned insolent when I told her to go for a shower, so I'm putting her on report now.
Sue, she's not handling things too well at the moment. Let me sort it out.
You're welcome.
And don't put her on report, please.
All right, you sort her out.
All right, Kent. Calm down. Let's go back to
the room.
Come on, Nemi.
Come on, will you?
Come on, let's
I'm sick of that being told when to wake me to sleep in this place.
Kent. Pull yourself together.
You lock me up in here and you take your kids away from me and
come
you won't let me see my kids. No!
Dr. Morrison, could I have a word with you about your accommodation?
Everyone is so concerned about my welfare.
No, it's not your welfare I'm concerned about, Doctor. It's the image of this hospital. Do you think it inspires confidence in our patients to see a member of the medical staff living like a tramp in the car park?
I take exception to that. Nellie is a perfectly worthy vehicle.
And well, she might be. But she will not be the instrument of turning the parking lot into a caravan park.
Sorry, I didn't think it would bother anyone.
Well, I'm back. So let's just forget about it, okay?
Rotten bastards. After stringing you along all that time.
Ferguson's gonna be worse than ever now.
What's plan B? We're all gonna get together and bash the hell out of her?
Oh, we'll have to. It's the only way of beating the bitch.
Maybe, maybe not.
Okay, so Barbara's agreed to lure the freak to isolation.
When?
Sometime after work. We can't guarantee what time she'll turn up, so we need a signal system. You can take care of that, Patty.
And then what? You gonna kill her or what?
I'm getting fed up with you. If I kill her, I ruin any chance I've ever got of a parole.
So what are you going to do? Give her a good talking to?
I'm going to put her in a hospital for a while, OK? I'll cop another 2 years. But it'll be worth it if it teaches her to keep off our backs.
You bloody piss weak bee. As soon as she comes back, you're as good as dead.
Well, it's my neck.
Well, you can count me out.
OK, Margot, watch the back stairs. Not many screws that come that way.
I told you, I'm not getting mixed up in it.
All right, Jacko, you bloody do it. This goes wrong because of you.
You're piss weak, B. There's only one way this thing would have worked, and it's my way.
Proceed.
The accused, Stephanie Jo Scully.
Straight.
In my experience, Miss Ramsey, our initial impressions are usually right. If viewed appropriate.
Just get on with it, Miss Fitzgerald.
Was your
How is that relevant?
Just stick to the facts, Miss Fitzgerald.
Yes, Your Honor.
Miss Fitzgerald, do you know where your learned friend and his client are?
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I have no idea.
I apologize, Your Honor. We are ready to proceed.
What a good idea.
Your Honor.
Oh, I hope the court doesn't get to hear about this little episode. They might not think you're a fit mother. And of course, there are lots of things that I'd be only too willing to tell the court. So clean this up. Come on, Latham. You can do better than that. Stupid little slut. I warned you, Latham. I warned you! Say anything or just get down to it. Come on, ladies. Speak up. I can guess who you are. Smith. Gaffney. Lawson. Fields.
Or I'll break her neck.
Oh, what's that, David? We can't risk that. Shut up.
case you lot have any other fancy ideas, just remember that your little friend will be dead before you lay a finger on me. Well, you must think you're so smart to set this up. Now, just stay right where you are. And that goes for you too. Because killing you means nothing to me. In fact, one less of you bastards would suit me fine. Right, now you. Here, unlock the gate. Come on, or I start pulling. Right, open the gate and your little friend lives. Congratulations. You really fooled me this time, Smith. How did you get Fields to set me up?
Shouldn't take much persuading. She's no friend of yours, Ferguson. Then no one is. Now, are you going to turn around and face me, or haven't you got the guts?
Oh, I thought I'd let you hit me from behind. It's more your style, isn't it?
Could have died last night. Asthma can be fatal.
I can't be held responsible, Mr. Wilson. I made you a very generous offer for your property, and Hackett Haven is going to be of great benefit to the community.
Oh, yeah, terrific, full of wealthy wrinklies. I'm talking about now. There's dust and vermin, machinery, people coming and going at all hours of the day and night.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. Apart from your family and my workmen, I've only seen one person there, just one. Just a minute, I have to ring the police.
Oh, typical. Call the police, claim I'm harassing you. You won't get away with this, Mrs. Hackett.
We're not culpable. The criminal is. And if it hadn't been for me recognising him...
Oh, there's a message from Beatrice White on your desk. She doesn't seem to think that Hackett Haven's a very good idea for the community.
Oh, that woman. Oh, she's a fine doctor, I'll give her that, but the woman's nothing more than a communist. Why shouldn't people who've worked hard all their lives, never been a burden on the taxpayer, why shouldn't they have a haven in their twilight years?
There are some things that money can't replace. Frank bought me these when we were holidaying in Europe. They didn't cost much, but they're priceless to me.
I understand.
I knew you would, Dan. And I want you to go around to the Wilsons and arrest their son.
Hang on a minute.
Jeff Wilson did this. He's the troublemaker who's been trying to stop me building the retirement home. I want you to take him in for questioning and make him admit it.
I'll put the fingerprint boys in first, but if you go accusing Jeff Wilson without any proof, you could be up on a defamation charge.
Well, I won't rest until I get that proof.
I believe you met my wife yesterday.
Ailsa? Oh, yes, lovely person. Tell me, Mr. Stewart, do you have any salmon?
Yeah, red or pink.
We like tuna.
I always gave Marilyn salmon when she was a child. In fact, I always saw to it that she had the best.
Well, Auntie, why don't you just choose whatever you'd like?
Oh, Mr. Stewart, do you have the smoked variety?
Yep, you're in luck. It came in this morning.
Oh, goody. Now, Marilyn, I want some of that English tea up there, too.
I'm not putting up with tea bags for anyone.
This is so much better than being in solitary. Don't you just love the ones that try to fight? Didn't some trusting screw tell you to just give in to the place? Oh, what's the matter? People usually love to talk to me.
Come on, move it, Gov.
I'm sorry I'm late, but I got a real good excuse. This has just been on the blower.
Well, I could do with a good surprise.
Well, this is a ripper. Morag just phoned to say that your parole's been approved effective immediately.
No.
She can certainly pull a rabbit out of that sister of mine, when she puts her mind to it, eh? Apparently she got your case moved forward on compassionate grounds.
Oh, well, let's get the hell out of here.
Whoa, hang on. They've got to officially inform your offsider out there first, and you're still a patient in this hospital.